Every field is filled with acronyms, and genealogy is no different, and particularly genetic genealogy. Today, we're going to cover the MRCA. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor stories along the way. Today, we're going to be talking about that acronym that you might have heard of as MRCA. What is an MRCA? Well, this one's actually very useful, and you're going to see it a lot. It stands for Most Recent Common Ancestor. MRCA, Most Recent Common Ancestor. Now, what is your most recent common ancestor? Well, that really is a comparison with you and somebody else. It's not just with you. So let's say you have a DNA match. Your most recent common ancestor is the ancestor that you both are related to. It's that simple. So let's go over to the shared CM tool at the chart on DNA Painter and use this to help us visualize most recent common ancestors. On this chart, we can see that our self is right here in the center, and we have all these potential relatives of ours. Well, for our most recent common ancestor, let's start with our sibling, our brother or our sister. Who is the most recent common ancestor of us and our siblings? Well, it's really easy because we both can trace right up to our parents. That's the most recent common ancestor. And you'll notice I said our parents. And that's where this can get really confusing because most recent common ancestor implies a single person, an individual. However, because every person has two parents, in a lot of cases, the most recent common ancestors is a couple. A father and a mother pair. The most recent common ancestor for our self and our siblings is our parents, both our mother and our father. On the other hand, if we are looking again at our self and we're looking at a half sibling, then our most recent common ancestor is not our parents, because we don't share both parents in common. We only share one of those parents in common. And so our most recent common ancestor would be that one parent, our mother or our father. Now that's really easy to visualize because siblings are right next to each other. We're usually part of the same family. Let's go and look at some other relationships. Let's start with our self right here. And if we want to go and take a look at, let's say, a second cousin, we're just going over a couple. Well, now we have to go up and see where the commonality is. If we go from ourselves up one and we go from that second cousin up one, it's still not the same person or persons. So we go up another one and we go up another one and we're still not at the same person or persons. So we go up a third one and up a third one, and now we are at our great grandparents. The most recent common ancestors of ourself and our second cousins is our great grandparents. As you can see, if we go and look at the half second cousins, it also is going to be a great grandparent, singular. Great-grandparent as opposed to a second cousin, which is going to be both of our great-grandparents. You're probably starting to see a pattern here. That is that the difference between whether the most recent common ancestor is an individual or if the most recent common ancestor is a couple is whether or not there is a half relationship. And so if we take a look at these half relationships over here, all of these are going to have a most recent common ancestor individual. So these are the individuals. I'm going to put individuals. jewel. On the other hand, everybody else over here is all going to be part of a couple. So if you're looking with half relationships, you're going to be looking for a single individual that you all share in common. Whereas if you are looking at full relationships, it is going to be a couple that is the most recent common ancestor that you share in common. We've looked at straight line across. So basically in the same generation, our second cousins are in the same generation as us. What about when we do generations removed? How do we find the most recent common ancestor? We'll start again with ourself. And this time, I'm going to use a half second cousin once removed. A half second cousin once removed. So I can go to myself and I don't have a match with them. And that only puts me on the same level as this half second cousin. So I'm going to go up again and they're going to go up one. We're going to go up again and they're going to go up one. And then we're going to go up again to the great great grandparent. And that's also where this half second cousin once removed goes. What we can learn from this is that if you are any kind of generations removed from that ancestor, it doesn't matter in order to find the most recent common ancestor. You still have to climb the same number of ways. Now, what it does make a difference is I had to go 1, 2, 3, 4 steps to get to that most recent common ancestor, and this match had to only go 1, 2, 3 steps to get to the most recent common ancestor. And that's how you get that how many generations removed. 3 minus 4 is -1, which is one generation removed. So far, we have always had ourself as one of those two that we're matching. What about if we are doing some research for another family member, and let's say that we have somebody who is a half second cousin to us, but we're also looking at a third cousin once removed for somebody else, for ourselves. Well, one of the things you need to be sure of is that whatever two people you're matching are in the same family, that they have a common ancestor. Now, for instance, let's say I have a second cousin, a half second cousin that I'm doing some research for, and I find that they are related to a third cousin of mine once removed. Who is the common ancestor between these two people? Now again, it's not myself anymore, but it is this half second cousin and this third cousin once removed. It's actually the exact same pattern. We're going to go and we're going to go up, and the third cousin once removed goes up, and now that's in the same generation as that half second cousin. Then they both go up and it's still not the same person. They both go up again and we're still not at the same people. Again, and finally again, and now we've gotten to the great-great-grandparents. Now, because this involved a half relationship, it's only one of those great-great-grandparents. So in this way, we can find out who the most recent common ancestor is based on our matches tree. In all of this, the most important thing to remember is if you have a half relationship, you have an individual as your most recent common ancestor. However, if you have no half relationships, then your most recent common ancestor is going to be a couple, a mother and a father. If you have questions about most recent common ancestors and how to determine who they are, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it for you. Be sure to like this video, giving it a thumbs up, and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already.